Okay, now after discussing the Poisson distribution and also the second distribution that we have discussed previously, now we'll go to discuss or explain the continuous probability distribution concept. And here it's a very important lecture because all random variables, not all actually, the all economic traits are belong to a continuous distribution that will be faced all of us in our future research or anything that we are dealing in our way in research and also in other in field work actually. We do need to know or to understand what do we mean by continuous variables. How can we differentiate between the continuous variables from what we call the discrete variables? Actually, we explain or we define previously the continuous variable as the one that can assume any value within a specific interval of values assumed by the variable. It can be said that as can be read as an infinite number of values between two limits. Actually, when we discussed it previously, I defined the continuous variables for all of you in the class. I said to you, imagine with me that we have a certain height. The height is a continuous, and if we take an interval between the first centimeter from 0 up to 1 centimeter, okay, we can see a huge number, infinite numbers, between 0 and 1. Maybe it, the numbers maybe goes to 0.01, 0.001, 0.002, up to the 1. This is if we take just only 1 centimeter. Now imagine with me that we will take 100 centimeter or 1 meter or another thing. This is the main definition on how can we deal with those. And this is the main example that we can differentiate between the discrete variable and also the continuous variable. So we need to understand that those continuous variables is one that can assume any value within a specific interval of values assumed by this variable. And the height example is a good example, and also the weight and also the age and anything related to the continuous variables. Now, the continuous random variable right here is the outcome. Now, the definition in the previous slide was as I said previously, but now if we want to deal with the CRV, it's a continuous random variable. It can be abbreviated like this, CRV, continuous random variable. It is the outcome of this continuous can be any value in an interval or collection of intervals. If we return back to the previous example that I give you in the previous slide, that we have a height or weight between just only 0 and 1 centimeter, 0 and 1 kilogram, 0 and another values. Now between 0 and 1, it is an interval. So we do need to predict actually the values between those intervals. In some cases, the interval the outcome may be 0.001. The interval maybe came like this, between 0.1 and 0.2, between 0.1 and 0.5, between 0.1 and 0.6, and so on. This is the outcome that give any value in an interval or collection of intervals. We can see it as continuous random variable, CRV. This is to be known for all of you. So, the example of CRV, as I said, it is a height. CRV, it's continuous random variable, is height. It is an example of the continuous. The time, the weight, and the money also. It can be treated as continuous, as a random variable. Now, after defining the continuous random variable and also the random variable itself, we do need to understand something extracted from those things. We can say that there is something that we do need to deal with actually in the future, in our future lectures on statistics. It's called probability density function. Probability density function For a continuous random variable x, it is a curve. Now we are dealing with curve now, such that the area under the curve over an interval equals the probability that x is in that interval. So imagine with me that we are dealing with continuous variable, and the probability for obtaining a certain value or interval, okay, between two random variables. So this interval, we can return back as a, think about it as a probability, and the probability characteristics is just only a curve. This curve, the area below the curve, under the curve, over an interval equal the probability that x is in that interval. So x will be in that interval below what we call the curve. And it can be read as this: the probability of x being under the curve, density curve, over the interval between the values a and b. So we can, p here is referred to the probability. As you see, p is the probability of being x is more than or equal to a and less than or equal to b. So a and b is an interval. So we are looking for x. We do need to understand to know x. So x is the probability of it will be located between within an interval. This interval is bordered by a and b, and we can read it like this: the probability of being x over greater than or equal to a, or less or equal to b. A and b here are the intervals. This is to be known also. You need to memorize this thing. We are dealing with curve. This curve, below it is a probabilities. Those probabilities are give us the probability between two intervals. We are looking for continuous variable. The continuous variable cannot be estimated directly. We cannot take a value. We are estimating what? Estimating some certain interval. Interval is, for example, here is between A and B. And we can predict that X is located between A and B, between the certain interval that we are looking for. This is how can we deal with the probability density function. Now, the continuous random variables, we have continuous random variables, CRV, as we discussed previously. We have some certain definition to be memorized also. A random variable is a variable having a single numerical value determined by a chance for each outcome of some procedures. This is random. How can we define this from this nomination? Okay, you can see a random variable. The random variable here is a random. We haven't a fixed number. We don't have fixed value to look for. It's a random variable having a single numerical value. It is just only one numerical value determined by a chance. From where we came, we take the randomness here from the chance. It's a chance for each outcome of some procedure. For example, if we take certain procedure, if we roll a dice, for example, what's the probability of obtaining 6? 6 is a numerical value, but here we have a random variable dealt with a continuous, in a continuous fashion, continuous values. The probability also, we have a probability distribution. Probability distribution describes the probability for each value of a random variable. So we have a random variable. It's a single numerical value determined by a chance. It's a random also. And also below it, we have the probability distribution, التوزيع اللي حكينا عنه, احتمالية التوزيع. So probability distribution بيعطينا, give us the probability for each value of the random variable. We defined the random variable previously, and now we'll go directly to define another thing, okay, called discrete random variable, DRV. The DRV, it has either a finite number of values or countable number of values, possible values that x can be assumed is 0, 1, 2, and so on. So the discrete random variable is totally different from the continuous variable, CRV. CRV is totally different from DRV. DRV here is abbreviated for, stands for a discrete random variable. Discrete random, it's a finite number. There is infinite number of values between two intervals, as we discussed or defined previously. So this grid هو متقطع وتباين متقطع تباين أو متغير متقطع. It can be as a countable number. We can count it. So directly we pick the number. We can count it, and it will give us a fixed value. Okay, and also it's a countable number. You can differentiate between your continuous and non-continuous variables as countable and non-countable. Okay, so the values of x here in the DRV or discrete random variable, it can be 0, 1, or 2, and so on. Now, continuous random variable, okay, you can call back, it has an infinitely number, many values. We can differentiate between this discrete and the continuous random variable. DRV is a finite number here, is infinitely many values. And those values are often associated with measurements or a continuous scale with no gaps or interruptions. So, as we see, if we want to differentiate between discrete and continuous variables, the discrete variable is a countable thing, finite number of values, okay, fixed number, 0, 1, 2, but here, CRV is infinite number of values or many values, okay, and also often associated with measurements. There, in the discrete, countable. Countable thing, okay, it's here, it's measurements or continuous scale without interruption, okay, it's scale without interruption. So you do need to differentiate between the DRV and the CRV here. DRV stands for discrete random variable, okay, the continuous random variable, it is CRV. For DRV, we can find, okay, for DRV, discrete random variable here, we can find the probability that the variables x exactly equals a specific value. We cannot do this for the CRV. This is also obviously discussed previously in the previous slides. For the CRV, the continuous random variable, we are only able to find the probability that x falls between two values. So we are dealing with what? Dealing with interval. The interval, we can specify a certain interval, and we can say that this value is located between the two variables, as we discussed, probability of x being is larger than or equal to a and b, and here a and b is an interval, okay, that we the x value located between those two limits of those of this interval, okay. So unlike the DRV, CRV do not have a probability distribution function, okay. Unlike DRV, CRV do not have a probability distribution function specifying the exact probability of specific values. This is also a certain well-known characteristics or difference between CRV and DRV. Instead, they have a probability density function that used to finite probability that the random variable falls into specific interval of values. So we do need to understand that in discrete variables, we have a certain function, certain values, okay? Certain values, we can specify a certain value because it's a countable thing, okay? In CRV here, we are dealing with a probability, okay? Dealing with interval, and we can say at the final step, in the final step, we can say that X or the value is located between this limit and the upper limit, because between two an interval, between intervals, okay? This interval has lower limit and also upper limit. So we have two values to be specified, and these two values, two limits, we can predict or assume that this value is located between those things, not a specific value at the discrete variable.